Hello, my name's John. This is the dragon from the Lego Dungeons & Dragons set, and you're watching Wargames Models and Other Hobbies. Hello and welcome back to another video. Today I'm going to be making the dragon from the Lego Dungeons & Dragons kit. I made the rest of this kit quite a while ago and the dragon's just been sitting around and I thought it was about time that I put it together. So in this video I'm just going to work through the instructions, building it. I might chat in places, I might speed it up, I'm not sure. But let's get started. Now, my personal preference when it comes to making Lego isn't organising or anything like that. It's have a bag, pile it out, and then start building from the instructions. So, Lego is another one of my hobbies. It's not something that I do as much as Warhammer, but I have always played Lego since I was a kid. I have quite an extensive collection that I've built up over the years. And in the recent years, when they've been releasing new updated sets, I have picked them up. If it's something that you'd like to see more of on this channel, please drop a comment. But every so often, I will put a Lego set up here. And I'm looking forward to the new Dungeons & Dragons minifigures that are coming out. And I will be ordering them. And what I'll probably do, because they come in blind boxes, is unbox them on the channel. And we'll see if I get the whole set or if I don't get the whole set. I know that Lego have limited it to, I think it's 24 packets, so 24 minifigures per person, so per household, I think. So you got a 1 in 24 chance on each of them. 1 in 24, I don't know, someone else will work out the odds. I got 24 chances to get all of them, but if you don't, then it's onto the internet and search for the ones that you don't get. But yeah, that's something that I'm looking forward to getting. And yeah, like I said, I do enjoy Lego sets. It's a nice hobby to have. It's a calming hobby, I think. Okay. So yeah, what I may do is when I'm quiet doing this, I'll put some background music in place so it's not just complete silence working. But yeah, it's a really nice put together kit, this one. The rest of the Dungeons & Dragons set is built really nicely, so you can have it as separate pieces or put it all together in one kind of one display piece. I think this part is either the lower end of the body or the top end of the body and the section for the neck. I'm not sure. We'll see as it starts to build out. So looking at this, this is the lower end of the body with the beginning of the tail. Oh, I missed that piece earlier. Yeah, the dragon itself totals 9 bags, which is a nice amount. Okay. 3 spare bits from that bag. Well, I hope they're spare. I'll find out later on. So we'll put this piece to one side. Gotta put my teeth in there. Let's move on to bag 26. So yeah, I do find I get impatient if I try and organise all the bits, and I quite like hunting through a pile of pieces. Rather than organising them first. Yeah, it's going together nice and easily, this set. It's not overly complicated. Okay, so that goes on there. And I'm presuming the next piece going to be this side. Yeah, if you'd like to see any of my other Lego sets, please drop a comment. I have what would be considered now quite a few vintage sets, which are the sets from my childhood that I've recently been putting back together. And it's got to the point where I'm going to have to start thinking about where I can put them, because once I build them, I don't like taking them apart again. But yeah, that's something that I've got to work out down the line. I don't live in a place big enough to have a Lego room, although that would be a dream. I do like the colours of this dragon as well. All the reds and oranges are really nice. It would be interesting to see how long it takes me to put this together. The thing I like as well with Lego helps exercise my bad thumb. A few years ago now, had a bit of an accident with a table saw and nearly lost the end of my thumb. But since then, if I don't use it much or kind of don't keep it moving, it does kind of get a little bit funky, let's say. And I have to kind of keep making sure I wake it up a little bit so I can feel out of the end of it, as I do lose sensation in it. But Lego, one of my childhood joys, is really good at keeping it mobile. That's my excuse anyway for carrying on with enjoying Lego. Or I don't need an excuse to enjoy it, I can just do it. Okay, there we go. Okay, so I'm on that side now. So I think these are either the points where the wings or the arms are going to go. Missed a few bits out there. I really do like how this is put together, actually. It's a really nice use of loads of small tiles that start to look like scales and things like that. But yeah, I'm really liking this kit already. Right, on to another bag. Four little spare bits from that one. So now to bag 27. One thing I have found, comparing the newer sets with the older LEGO sets, the older instructions were a lot less forgiving, so to speak. The amount of information that you were given on number of parts per step wasn't as good as it is now. Although it was more challenging, and to some that might be enjoyable. I did enjoy it, I still do. But yeah, there is a notable difference with how the kits are kind of described nowadays. Got quite a few old sets that I really like. So yeah, like I said, if anyone wants to see any of those, drop it in the comments. So these bits look like they're the tail. Be interesting to see the size of this when it's done as well. It does look quite big on the box. Until you've built them, you never know. I like the way that this tail is going together. Okay, tail's coming along nicely there. That is quite a large model so far. Ooh, lots of spikes on the tail. Okay, so a few spare bits from that bag, and here we have that so far. Let's bend this tail so it fits on camera for now. Okay, bag 28. Oops. Thank you. So this looks like it's the wings. Thank you. Thank you. final bag. Okay, let's zoom out and have a look at this completed dragon. So here it is, the Dungeons and Dragons Lego dragon. Really nice part of the kit, this one. As I said at the beginning, I made the rest of the kit quite a while ago, and the dragon's just kind of been sitting around for quite a while. So it was about time I put it together. I really like the different points of articulation that they've put into this. So you've got the tail, you've also got the legs to a certain extent. The wings themselves fold completely flat or stay up quite high, which I really quite like. It does mean that you could actually position the dragon up on its hind legs. Yeah, it's a really nice piece, this one. I think to get an idea of the size of it, it'd be nice to compare it to some of the other figures and models that you get in the Dungeons and Dragons kit. So firstly, I've got two of the heroes that come with the kit. We have the Orc Rogue and the Gnome Fighter. Just hold them up to the camera there. So these are some of my favourite ones from the kit. And if we compare the dragon in size to each of them, you can see that it's a hefty monster, this one. It's a really nice piece. And then if we compare it to some of the other beasts, the monsters that you get, these are two of my favourites. So there's the owlbear, which I really like the way that that one went together, and a beholder. But if we compare the size of these ones, you can see it is still, it's a hefty model, that dragon, compared to these ones. I like all the items that come with this Dungeons and Dragons kit. And as I said during the video, if you want to see any of my other Lego projects, my other kits, I do have some quite old vintage ones from when I was a kid. I'd be happy to share them. Just drop a comment and I'll see what I can do to put a video together showing those. Whether you want them to be a building video or just a show and tell, I don't mind. Entirely up to you guys. Just drop it in the comments. But now I've finished this dragon, I'm looking forward to getting the minifigure sets that are coming out soon. Like I said, I'll do a video on unboxing those when I get them. It'll be a blind unboxing, so I'm going to get to see if I get the whole set or I'm going to have to go searching for some of them. But we shall see. So I hope you've enjoyed this video. If you have, I'd appreciate it if you drop a like. But all I've got to say now is thanks for tuning in. My name's John, and you've been watching War Games, Models, and Other Hobbies.